Hi guys, welcome to channel Piping Mantra. For today, we are here with a new exciting interview questions video for piping. Our intent is to help all the piping engineers and designers out there in cracking every interview in these tough times. So, without making this intro any longer, let's get into our video. Also, if you guys have any questions regarding any topic in piping, please drop in the comment section below. We will try and answer it in this ongoing interview question series. So let's get started. First, where do we use concentric and eccentric reducers? Normally, we use eccentric reducers in horizontal pipes to maintain the bottom of pipe, in pump suction to avoid cavitation, in PSV outlet, and we use concentric reducers in vertical pipe runs, pump discharge, PSV's inlet. Next, where do we provide high point vent HPV and low point drain, that is LPD, in piping? HPV is used for removing air during hydro test, and LPD is used for draining water after conducting hydro test. You can watch our detailed videos on this topic. If you wish to pursue piping course under Piping Mantra, please fill out a Google form attached in the description box below. This will help us in arranging the logistics to start the course. Next, why is weep hole provided at true nails? It is provided for venting of hot gas which may get generated due to welding. Next, what are weldolets and socolets? Where they are used? Weldolets and socolets are self-reinforced fittings. Weldolet is for butt welded branch connection and socolet is for socket welded branch connection, which requires reinforcing pad and where standard T cannot be used because of size restrictions. Next, what is upstream and downstream? To remember this, consider a river flowing in one direction. Now, if we put a twig or foot piece in the river, the natural direction of flow is the downstream and the opposite direction is the upstream. For determining upstream and downstream, the flow of direction of pipe service must be known first. Next, what is the upstream and downstream values for an orifice flow meter? In general, the value considered for upstream and downstream are 15D and 5D respectively. However, this requirement may change based on piping configuration. In some cases, it might be 25D and 5D respectively. Next, from which side will you take a branch connection? For gas, air or steam and cryogenic services, we take branch connection from top side. And when fluid is liquid, we take branch connections from bottom side. But nowadays, you can take top tapping in all cases until and unless we have free drain requirement. Next, what is the difference between process vent and drains and hydrostatic vent and drains? Process vent and drains have valves and are always shown on the PNIDs, whereas hydrostatic vents and drains do not have valves on them and are not shown on the PNIDs unless they have valves in rare situations. Next, what should be the radius of a long radius elbow? 1.5D, where D is the diameter of the pipe. Next, what should be the radius of a short radius elbow? It should be 1D, where D is the diameter of the pipe. Next, what is the basis of using of short radius and long radius elbow? Long radius elbow are used for small pressure drop, whereas short radius elbows are used for high pressure drops. For catalyst flow, very long elbows are also used. Next, why concentric reducers is not used in pump suction? Air pockets may form if concentric reducer is used at pump suction, which results in cavitation and may cause damage to pump. To avoid this problem, eccentric reducer with flat side up, that is FSU, is used in pump suction. Next, where the ERW and seamless pipes are used. above 18 inch ERW pipes are used and below 18 inch seamless pipes are used. Seamless pipes can sustain higher temperature and pressure. Next, what is the main use of ASTM A53 and A106 grade B pipes? ASTM A53 pipes are mainly used for utility services, whereas A106 grade B pipes are used for high pressure and high temperature services. So that is it guys for today's video. We love reading your comment and suggestions, so please comment below. We do read every single one of your comment. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends and colleagues who may find it useful. If you have any time, please check out our other videos over there.